Good evening guys and welcome back. I think this news can make you a bit happy if you are a Reliance Communication Limited investor. Yes guys, this is the latest update received from the company side regarding the creditors of committee meeting that is gonna be conducted guys. So what are the details that are gonna see now guys? So on January 7th today we have received the mail. From the BSE, I have received the mail regarding that committee of creditors to be held on January 8, 2020. So the first thing we can see from here is they are going to meet tomorrow. But guys, do you notice that from the previous year this company is conducting the creditors of committee meeting guys? So as per the listing and obligations and disclosures, they have said that 16th meeting of committee of creditors guys. Yes, this is the 16th creditors of committee meeting they are going to conduct convened on January 8, 2020. So what is the main thing that you are going to see tomorrow? That's the main topic of today guys. As you know, previous year Reliance Jio said that it will acquire the whole Reliance Communications. The brothers were in talks regarding that stake acquisition, but it ended in vain, stating that there are numerous issues that has been created. So neither both of them could able to get those deal successfully. And recently Bharati Airtel said that they are building to pay 9,500 crores. I repeat, 9,500 crores to acquire Reliance Communications arm stakes, etc. I think so guys. Yes, so this is the main thing that is gonna be important about Reliance Communication tomorrow. Yes, people who have invested their heavy money those days, from the day when it jumped from 10 rupees to 40 rupees during the news of Reliance Communication acquisition by the Reliance CEO, and the same movement could happen tomorrow if this Reliance Communication gets the deal done correctly and if any successful bid has been done. And the main thing is that if you are holding Reliance Communication, what you should do, people will ask me, and there's a reply to Reliance Communication shareholders. So first of all, I will split this answer into two guys. Listen it carefully, don't skip this, this is very very important. I will skip this answer into two. The first answer is for a trader. A trader is a short term buyer and seller. To those traders, my advice would be, if you want to make up some profit, sell on those highs and come out and buy the shares at lower circuit. As you can see, the 2 days to 3 days back when the share was swing at 1.20, you could have sell there and buy it now guys. So investors, the long-term investors, to those people who are holding their shares believing something will going to happen to this share, that's a good news for you guys. If this deal happens successfully, then the share may go up to back again, or there may be a chances of Bharati Airtel merger with Reliance Communication, which would be super and nice thing to hear guys. As once upon a time, I was a Reliance Communication shareholder. This is a disclaimer portion, but I was a Reliance Communication shareholder. Luckily, I sold at the level of 38 rupees and came out. But the problem with this share is that there is no permanent classification as when this is going to complete. As you can see here, guys, the 16th meeting is going to be conducted. Then already 15 meetings has been done, and in this, two meetings have been finalized, but all has been disposed. Hoping tomorrow will be a good thing for Reliance Communication, and hoping so, all good things will come to all investors. If you like this news, then why not subscribe to us guys? Try it out. You will get latest updates and many news regarding many shares guys. And don't forget to share this video to your friends so that you could and they could learn more things from the stock market. See you in another video guys. Until then, bye from our channel.